Topic in the video belongs to moving charges and magnetism lesson. Learning outcomes of this video are Baird-Savart's law. Baird-Savart's law application, that is magnetic induction at a point on the axis of a circular current carrying conductor. And finally, example problems.
Namaste students, this is Chalapati, faculty in physics. Now I am going to explain the details about Baird-Savart's law and one of the application of Baird-Savart's law, that is magnetic induction at a point on the axis of a current carrying circular loop and few problems in that topic. Before going to the topic, so let me show the current carrying coil physically. So for example, consider a current carrying coil. For suppose the current passing in this coil, for example, you can see the circular loop, but according to the diagram in the topic, it will be perpendicular to the display. And the current I consider in the diagram, so here at the top of the circular coil, current coming outward, that is outward to the display, and at the bottom, current going inward, means with respect to me, the current is in clockwise direction. Now you can apply Ampere's law. According to Ampere's law, you can analyze the current direction due to this circular current carrying coil. So here I said current direction coming outward. So if you apply the right hand thumb rule, then thumb direction is the current direction, then curling of fingers coming like this. Means the magnetic lines of force going in this direction. Means here it will be north pole, this side it will be south pole. Okay, it is acting like a bar magnet. Now our topic, at the center magnetic induction we have to find out. For example, here that yellow point, just consider as a center, and another yellow point is there. At that point we want to measure the magnetic induction. That is the topic. Okay, now the major point you have to analyze, that is from this point the current carrying coil, any point will be at same distance. Say for example, at this point we have to find out the magnetic induction. That point is at same distance from any point on the circular loop. Okay, that is one important point. And one more, so according to this wire, for example, this is the radius vector. That radius vector always perpendicular to the length element of the coil. Here the length element and coil, you can see. So length element and coil both will be perpendicular every time. So here the angle will be perpendicular. Why? Because this coil we kept perpendicular to the display and we are observing at a particular point here. So everywhere, if you consider a small length element, that length element will make 90 degrees with the radius vector, what we consider from the length element to the point P. Let's go to the video.
Baird-Savart's law. Baird and Savart studied about the current carrying conductors and magnetism produced by the current carrying conductors. So they analyze the magnetic induction produced by the current carrying conductors and they gave four factors which affecting the magnetic field produced by the current carrying conductors. To analyze that one, consider a current carrying conductor XY. For suppose I is the current passing through the conductor, and for example the conductor is divided into infinitesimally very small elements, for example like DL. Now at a particular point, due to this small DL element, what is the magnetic induction at that point? So they expressed one equation. So with respect to that, we can get the magnetic induction produced by any type of current carrying conductor, any type in the sense either straight line or coil or rectangular shape. So for different shaped current carrying conductor, magnetic induction we can get by using this Baird-Savart's law. So for that purpose, they designed the magnetic induction due to small element DL. So due to the small element DL, the magnetic induction produced is they consider as a small quantity, that is dB. If you want the total, we have to integrate. If you integrate dB, you will get the magnetic induction produced by the entire current carrying conductor. Now to get the magnetic induction at a particular point point P, which is at a distance r from the length element, which is making an angle t, theta. So here theta is the angle between length element and r radius vector. So here the length element we are taking as a vector. Reason, it is infinitesimally small. Even though the wire is a curve, if you consider a very small length element, that we can treat as a straight line. So dl is a vector and r is also a vector. So theta is the angle between length element dl and radius vector r. Now according to Biot-Savart's law, the magnetic induction dB depends upon four factors. Let us see one by one. So according to Biot and Savart, the magnetic induction produced at this point P dB is directly proportional to the current flowing through the conductor. Means if current is more, magnetic induction produced at this point will be more. So that we can express like this, dB proportional to I. And the dB is directly proportional to the length element dl. So if wire length is more, then magnetic induction produced at this point will be more. So that mathematically we can express as dB proportional to dl. The third factor is magnetic induction at point P dB is directly proportional to the sine of the angle between length element and r. So if theta is 0, then magnetic induction produced will be 0. If theta equals to 90 degrees, the magnetic induction at that point will be more. So that mathematically we can write as dB proportional to sine theta. Next, fourth factor, if you consider the point very near to the current carrying conductor, then magnetic induction will be more. If you go little bit away from the current carrying conductor, the magnetic induction decreases. That is, the magnetic induction produced by this small dl current carrying element, that is dB, is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the length element and point considered. So that mathematically we can represent dB proportional to 1 by r square. So collectively all four points we can write like this, dB proportional to idl sin theta by r square. Here we can introduce a proportionality constant, that is dB equals to mu naught by 4 pi into idl sin theta by r square. So here mu naught by 4 pi is the proportionality constant, and that is nothing but mu naught, permeability of a free space. The value is 10 to the power of minus 7. So mu naught value 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 unit Weber per ampere meter, or only just mu naught by 4 pi means 10 to the power of minus 7. In vector form, we can write the expression like this, dB bar equals to mu naught I by 4 pi into dl sin theta by r square into r cap. So to represent this is as a vector, so r cap unit vector we can add. Now further, this unit vector we can write like this, unit vector means vector by magnitude of the vector according to the definition of unit vector. So dB bar equals to remaining mu naught by 4 pi into idl sin theta by r square as usual, only instead of r cap, vector by magnitude of that vector. So now r magnitude r square, if you multiply both, resultant will be r cube, and at a numerator r bar is a vector and dl is a vector, and here sin theta is there. So total collectively we can write as it is vector, dl vector and r vector. So we can write as cross product. Why? Because here sin is there, so we can write as cross product of two vectors. So dB bar equals to mu naught I by 4 pi into dl bar cross r bar by r cube. So here be careful, if it is magnitude, denominator only r square. If you represent in vector, then only denominator r cube. So in some books the notation will be like this also, means vectors they will indicate with bold letters. So dB bar, dl bar and r bar. So here dB is a magnetic induction, it is a vector quantity. So resultant direction, so according to the cross product between the two vectors, we can say the resultant direction of magnetic induction is in the direction perpendicular to the plane containing dl bar and r bar according to the vector cross product details cross product of any two vectors is the resultant vector perpendicular to the plane containing the two vectors. So here dl bar and r bar both are in the direction of, means in the plane of the display. So the magnetic induction will be perpendicular to the dl bar and r bar, means it is perpendicular to the display. So perpendicular to the display in the sense maybe inward or outward, that you can analyze according to Ampere's law or according to right hand grip rule for vectors. So for that, just keep your right hand four fingers coinciding with dl, and afterwards that fingers we have to close in such a manner, we have to keep your hand. So just keep your four fingers of your right hand coinciding with dl and close comfortably towards r bar, then your thumb indicates inward. So that means the magnetic induction inward, so that we can represent with one cross. Okay, if you represent with dot and circle, that means magnetic induction perpendicularly outward to the display. So this one we can analyze with respect to Ampere's law also. So Ampere's law, you can see here. So current carrying conductor, current direction if you indicate with your right hand thumb, curling of fingers indicates the magnetic induction. So here according to the current direction, keep your thumb in the direction of current, then the curling of fingers will go inward. So at point P, magnetic induction will be inward. So that is why here indication into. So into indicates the magnetic field perpendicularly inward. Next, magnetic field at an axial point of a current carrying conductor. It is the application of Biot-Savart's law. So it's a very important application. So consider a current carrying loop or current carrying coil. For example, I is the current passing through this coil. So this coil, so according to the diagram it is looking like in the plane, actually it is perpendicular to the plane, means perpendicular to the display. For example, current passing direction you can see in the diagram. So with respect to point P, if you observe the current passing in anti-clockwise direction. For suppose, due to this current carrying conductor, our aim to identify the magnetic induction at a point P which is at a distance x from the center. For example, consider a point P and that is at a distance r from any length element small dl considered on the circular current carrying conductor. So entire current carrying conductor, imagine it consists of n number of dl elements, means we can divide into n number of dl elements. So one of the dl element is at a distance r, means all length elements, dl elements will be at the same distance. Why? Because this is a circular coil and it is perpendicular to the display. So that is why all points on the circular current carrying conductor is at same distance with P, and the line joining the dl and point P is making an angle alpha with the axis of the circular coil. And consider A is the radius of the circular coil, then you can analyze the current I producing magnetic induction in the direction, you can see PM, in the direction of PM. So that also you can analyze with respect to Ampere's law. For example, here I said already this circular coil is in the plane perpendicular to the display. So that means this dl element is perpendicularly outward or just inward, you can say anything. So according to the current, for example, dl element you can consider as according to the current direction. For example, dl element is perpendicularly outward or perpendicular to the display. That means dl and r both are perpendicular to each other. Now due to this current carrying element dl, at point P the magnetic induction direction according to Ampere's law, so that you can see in the previous diagram also I mentioned. So just analyze according to Ampere's law. For example, current passing in this direction, then, so current carrying conductor producing the magnetic field around the current carrying conductor. For example, I is the current. Now you can imagine n number of circular magnetic lines. For example, one circular magnetic line is making an angle R for suppose. Then the radius vector and the direction of magnetic field if you analyze. So consider a point here. The magnetic induction is perpendicularly outward. So here if you observe, the magnetic field perpendicularly inward. So that means the direction of magnetic field always makes angle 90 degrees with the radius vector. So here magnetic field perpendicularly inward, with the radius it is making an angle 90 degrees. So here the radius vector, here R is the radius vector, it should make an angle 90 degrees with the magnetic field. So here is the magnetic field should make angle 90 degrees. So now observe carefully. So here already alpha angle we considered, and consider it is a y axis. So that means with respect to axis of this circular coil, the total angle 90 degrees, x axis and y axis, so angle should be 90 degrees, it is alpha. So the remaining angle is 90 minus alpha. And as well as with this radius vector, magnetic field making an angle 90 degrees, and that the angle is 90 minus alpha, so remaining angle it should be alpha. So that means the magnetic field produced by the current carrying element DL making an angle alpha with the y axis. So here DB is making an angle alpha with the y axis, so it will be resolved into two components. One is adjacent component, that is DB cos alpha, and another one is DB sin alpha along x axis. Now for this DL element, we can consider exactly opposite element, or for each DL element, opposite element will be there. So for each DL element, exactly opposite DL element will be there. So here if you consider opposite DL element, so here current coming outward, so here current will go inward. So now apply Ampere's law here also. So here current going inward, so with respect to this, current inward means, just imagine, keep your thumb perpendicularly inward to the display, then curling of fingers will come in the direction PN. So that means magnetic induction produced by this current carrying element DL here will produce magnetic induction along PN, that is also DB. So here for our convenience here representing DB dash, but that is also DB. Now so that DB is also will make an angle alpha, same like. So here we consider this is as alpha, so then remaining it will be 90 minus alpha, and this radius vector and the magnetic field direction should make 90 degrees. So this is already 90 minus alpha, so this should be alpha. Now this DB should make components. So along y axis DB cos alpha, along x axis that is DB sin alpha. Okay. Now here with respect to this DL element, the magnetic induction along y axis is DB cos alpha. So with respect to this DL element here, what you consider here, so with respect to this DL element, the magnetic induction will come along negative y axis. So both will be get cancelled. That means every time due to this DL element, exactly opposite DL element will be there. So both will be get cancelled. So that means the magnetic field you will get every time along x axis only, that is DB sin alpha. So due to DL element, you will get magnetic induction DB sin alpha, that is only along x axis. That means due to this current carrying element, the total magnetic induction you will get every time along x axis as like a bar magnet placed along x axis. So this is equivalent to the bar magnet. So let us see further quantity of DB. For that, consider Biot-Savart's law. According to Biot-Savart's law, the magnetic induction produced by the current carrying element small DL, that is DB equals to mu naught by 4 pi into I into DL cross R bar by R cube. So it is a vector form I consider, and here the angle between DL bar and R bar, that is 90 degrees, and as well as here R. So R is the hypotenuse to the triangle. For example, consider triangle POC. So according to this triangle, hypotenuse R equals to square root of a square plus x square. So we can write R equals to square root of a square plus x square, or a square plus x square whole power 1 by 2. And the angle between DL and R bar is 90 degrees. So if you substitute that one here, or if you analyze individually DL bar cross R bar, so that is DL R sine 90 degrees. So sine 90 degrees value 1. So that is why only DL R. So that is only magnitude. So here I want to give the expression only in magnitude. So that is why direction I am not considering now. Further, if you substitute instead of DL bar cross R bar, only DL R in the expression and as well as R value, you will get first magnetic induction due to that small DL element, that is dB equals to mu naught by 4 pi into I DL bar cross R bar instead of that DL R by R cube. So here R here cube get cancelled, only square will be there. Further, you will get dB equals to mu naught IDL by 4 pi R square. Further, the magnetic induction along x axis. So here we already analyzed, that is the resultant current carrying coil will produce magnetic field only along x axis. Y components will be get cancelled every time. So that magnetic induction due to this small DL element is dB sin alpha, not dB according to Biot-Savart's law, dB expression, but according to the circular current carrying coil due to this DL element, the magnetic induction will be dB sin alpha. So if you want the total value, you have to integrate. So B, total magnetic induction equals to integral dB sin alpha. So instead of dB, if you write this expression, then it will be integral mu naught by 4 pi into IDL by R square into sin alpha. Now further, instead of sin alpha, from the diagram we can consider, so same triangle what we considered previously, POC. In that triangle, sin alpha equals to opposite side A by hypotenuse R. So sin t alpha equals to A by R. So that we substitute in this expression. Same expression I consider. Now instead of sin alpha, A by R, if you substitute, then B equals to mu naught I by 4 pi into integral DL by R square into, instead of sin alpha, A by R. Now R into R square R cube, and this R cube is a fixed value, so we can write outside also. So then finally we can write all constant, A is constant, R cube is constant. If you write outside, then B equals to mu naught I A by 4 pi R cube into, only DL is a small element, if you integrate you will get the total element. So integral DL. For a circular coil we consider small DL element, if you integrate you will get the entire circumference of the circular coil. So circumference of the circular coil with radius A, that is 2 pi A. So integral DL will be 2 pi A. So if you substitute that value, and as well as instead of R cube, so R expression we got already. So R cube means a square plus x square whole power 3 by 2. So we already analyzed here, R means square root of a square plus x square, or a square plus x square whole power 1 by 2. So that 1 by 2 whole cube, R cube is there. So whole cube means whole power 3 by 2 you will get. Now if you substitute R cube value and as well as integral DL value in the equation, B equals to, if you substitute DL value and R cube value, so DL value 2 pi A and R cube value A square plus X square whole power 3 by 2. So further we can simplify, pi pi get cancelled and 2 divided 4 by 2 times. So the final expression will be B equals to mu naught I A square by 2 into A square plus X square whole power 3 by 2. So this is the magnetic induction produced by the current carrying coil at a point which is at a distance x from the center. Now, different cases also we can analyze now. But before that, what we discussed one point, the direction of magnetic induction along the axis of the loop. So that is why we can treat this current carrying coil as a bar magnet. Now, different cases. For example, if there are n number of turns, here this is a circular coil we analyze. For example, the circular coil is having two turns, then you will get two times of this magnetic induction. For example, there are three turns, you will get 3 into this value. If there are n turns, you will get n into this value. So n into this value means simply we can write B equals to mu naught n into I a square by 2 into a square plus x square whole power 3 by 2. So this is the magnetic induction due to the current carrying coil of n number of turns. Next, now as a case. Case 1, magnetic induction at the center of the loop or coil. So at the center, if you consider a point at a distance x, then x value will be defined. If you consider the point on the center, that means x will be 0. So if x is 0, then the magnetic induction at the center, so this is the derived formula, in that x will be 0. If you substitute x value 0, then you will get mu naught ni a square by 2 into a square plus instead of x 0 square whole power 3 by 2. So a square plus 0 square means a square, so a square whole power 3 by 2. So now further, here a square square and whole power 3 by 2, 2 get cancelled, so the denominator only a cube. So B equals to mu naught ni a square by 2 a cube. Again, here a square square and cube get cancelled, then finally we'll get magnetic induction B equals to mu naught ni by 2 a. So this is the magnetic induction due to circular current carrying coil at the center, which is having n number of turns. Case 2, if you consider the point on the axis which is at a long distance, that means x is very much greater than a, means as compared with the radius of the coil, the point considered is at a far distance, then the magnetic induction. So this is the derived formula. So in that x is very high, so then a square can be neglected. If you neglect, then you will get the numerator as usual, so denominator 2 into, if you remove a square, then x square whole power 3 by 2. So here x square square and this 2 get cancelled. So you will get magnetic induction B equals to mu naught ni a square by 2 x cube. But here we can multiply this expression with pi and we can divide with pi. If you do like this, then here pi a square. So here a means radius of the coil. So pi a square will represent the area. So therefore we can write B equals to mu naught ni a by 2 pi x cube. So that means here magnetic induction depends upon one more parameter that we can analyze, that is proportional to area of the coil. If you design small cross-sectional area coil, then you will get a small magnetic induction. If you want more magnetic induction, you should pass more amount of current, and the number of turns you should make more, and as well as the area also should be more. And the point, if you want magnetic induction more, the point you have to consider very near to the coil. So that is inversely proportional to cube of the distance. So here A nothing but area of the loop or coil. Next, the magnetic field B varies non-linearly with distance. Why? Because here B inversely proportional to x cube. So it is not following a proportionality relation. So we can represent with a graph like this. So at the center, we came to know that at the center x is 0, if you substitute denominator, reduced. So the value will be more. So at the center of the coil, magnetic induction is more. If you go from the coil towards left or towards right, magnetic induction decreases drastically, but it will not follow a linear graph. It is a non-linear. Next, one problem. So according to the problem, a 2 ampere current is flowing through a circular coil of radius 10 centimeter containing 100 turns. Find the magnetic flux density at the center of the coil. So given data, current radius of the coil, number of turns. So if you write one by one, first solution given, first current I 2 ampere, radius 10 centimeters. So be careful here, it is given in centimeter and ampere is SI system of unit. So here centimeter centi we can write as 10 to the power of minus 2, then it will be in meter. So 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. So 10 into 10 to the power of minus 2, nothing but 10 to the power of minus 1 meter. Next, number of turns 100. Now we have to find out the magnetic flux density, that is B. So that is at the center. So formula, magnetic induction at the center of the coil B equals to mu naught Ni by 2R. If you substitute all the values here, mu naught value they did not give, but we have to remember, but in general they will give in CBSE examination and entrance examination they will give. So that mu naught value 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7 and N 100 into I value, current value 2 ampere by 2 into R value 10 to the power of minus 1 meter. So here 2 get cancelled. And further, 10 to the power of minus 1, if you shift it to numerator, it will be plus 1. So minus 7 plus 1, so it will be minus 6. So 4 pi, so 4 into 3.14 into 10 to the power of minus 6 into 100. So 10 to the power of minus 6 into 100, nothing but 10 to the power of minus 4. So finally 4 into 3.14, nothing but 12.6 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So units will be Weber per meter square or Tesla. But 10 to the power of minus 4 Tesla means 1 gauss. So we can also write like this, B equals to 12.6 gauss, that is in CJ system. Next problem 2. The magnetic induction at the center of the circular current carrying conductor of radius R is BC. Radius R they mentioned. The magnetic field on its axis at a distance R from the center is BA. So here distance x also they mentioned as r. So radius r, distance also r, but values they did not give, they mentioned with symbols, asking the ratio of BC by BA. So for that given data, if you write radius r they mentioned and the magnetic induction at the center mentioned as BC, at a particular distance r they mentioned as BA. So now we know that magnetic induction at the center of the current carrying conductor, that is BC, expression we know, that is mu naught I by 2R. So here number of turns they did not mention, that means 1 turn, so mu naught I by 2R. But at a particular point, the magnetic induction at a point on the axis, distance they mentioned R, x equals to R. So if you substitute instead of x R, then mu naught I R square by 2 into R square plus instead of x also R, so R square. So resultant is R square plus R square, 2R square. So 2R square whole power 3 by 2. Further, if you write whole power 3 by 2 at the denominator as individually 2 power 3 by 2 R square whole power 3 by 2, then you will get the expression like this. So mu naught I R square as usual at the numerator, denominator 2 into 2 power 3 by 2 R square whole power 3 by 2. R square square and 3 by 2, 2 get cancelled, then R cube. So again R square cube get cancelled, denominator only R will be left out. So BA equals to mu naught I by 2 R into 2 power 3 by 2. So now the ratio BC by BA equals to, so BC we got mu naught I by 2 R and BA mu naught I by 2 R into 2 power 3 by 2. So here mu naught I get cancelled, mu naught I and 2R, 2R get cancelled, then only thing left out to 2 power 3 by 2, it is denominator to the denominator, it will go to numerator. So therefore BC by BA equals to 2 power 3 by 2. This is the answer. Thank you, one and all.